Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese, Raman covering chemistry. Today, in Unit 8 redox reaction, that is video number 7, we are going to discuss about how to find oxidation number of a given element. Okay, so it can be a metal, what we say most probably, or non-metal, whichever it is given, we will find the oxidation number. But to know this, you have to go through the video 4, 5 and 6. 4, 5 and 6 videos. Now when we say 4, 5 and 6 videos, they were about rules for writing oxidation number. Okay. So without this 3 videos, you will not understand anything in this. Okay. So you have to go through that full video, that is 4, 5 and 6, what we have discussed previously. Okay. Now, when we need to assign oxidation number, there are certain things you have to remember about oxygen and halogen. Clear? And also about hydrogen. Okay? Hydrogen, we have seen an exception, that is hydrogen when it is connected to a metal or attached to a metal, it has negative. That is sodium hydride, when we say NaH. Okay? That time hydrogen is having -1. Other time hydrogen is having +1. Oxygen we have seen, it is -2 actually, but in some cases, that is superoxides are there, peroxides are there, their oxidation numbers are different. Superoxides are there, it is minus if you see half or 0.5, clear? And when we say about peroxide, it is -1, okay? So these all are the things what we have discussed till now, okay? Then halogens, when we say fluorine will always have -1 oxidation number, while the chlorine, bromine and iodine will have positive or negative oxidation number. Okay, so this was all about the rules what we have discussed. Go through these videos first, otherwise you will not understand anything in this video. Understood? So first of all, go through this video thoroughly and full videos. Many of the students are watching half videos. You are in loss, not the teacher. Is it clear? So be careful in that. Understood? Now we will start with what we call it as how to find the oxidation number. Okay? Okay. Now in your exercise of redox reaction, there is a question number 1. In exercise question, assign oxidation number to the underlined element in each of the following. Now when we say that, the first one, first example, question 1. Of exercise of textbook. Yeah. Now it is given that NaH2PO4. Right? So now NaH2PO4. Now in this case, now they have underlined, if you see here, phosphorus means you have to find the oxidation number of phosphorus. So whichever oxidation number you want to find, you keep this as X, what we said. That is, let the oxidation number of phosphorus be X in NaH2PO4. Understood? Then what to do? Sodium we know. It is +1. Okay. So what I'll write here? +1 plus hydrogen, it is 2. So 2 into hydrogen is again +1. Understood? Plus phosphorus, instead of phosphorus I will write X, plus oxygen we know, it is 4 here. So 4 into -2 for oxygen, means oxygen -2, this is +1, +1 and this is X, which is equal to 0, like this. Okay, this is the method of finding oxidation number. Now, 1 plus 2 plus X plus -8 is equal to 0, that is what? And this we will sum up. So what it will be? 3 plus X minus 8 is equal to 0. X is equal to, it will be what? X will be minus 8 and plus 3. So it will be minus 5 is equal to 0. So X is equal to plus 5. Okay. So X is equal to plus 5. Therefore, oxidation number of phosphorus is +5. Understood? So this is the thing what we have discussed in your book. Okay. Now one second question is there, related to same thing what we say. One second question, that is find the oxidation number of NaHSO4 in that sulfur you have to find. Just a minute. Second question is about NaHSO4. NaHSO4. Now in this you have to find oxidation number of sulfur. So what we will do, we will take, let the sulfur be X in NaHSO4. Understood? So now we will start with the sodium plus 1, hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2. For this all you have to see the what I said, that video numbers. Now, so plus 1, that is of hydrogen, this is of sodium, plus sulfur I'll take it as X, and oxygen 4 into minus 2 is equal to 0. So 1 plus 1 plus X minus 8 is equal to 0. X minus 6, I have sum of these three things. Okay. The X minus 6 is equal to 0. The X is equal to plus 6. Right? So what is the meaning of that? X was taken sulfur. So oxidation number of sulfur is plus 6. Understood this part? Okay. So this was second sum. Now we will see the third one. Okay. Now third one, when we say here, third one question, when we say third one, it is given H4P2O7. It is H4P2O7. H4P2O7. Okay. In this case also, we have to find oxidation number of phosphorus. They have underlined this phosphorus. Okay. Now, this is little bit different, so be careful. So, phosphorus be X in H4P2O7. No? This is the method, you have to write directly, don't write, you will not get marks in that. Okay, hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2, phosphorus I will take it as X. So 4 into plus 1, this is for hydrogen, plus phosphorus here, see 2 is there, no? So 2 into X I will say, so 2X it is. Okay, so this is the important part what you have to remember. Okay, plus 7 into minus 2 is equal to 0. So 4 plus 2x minus 14 is equal to 0. 2x minus 10 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 by 2. The x is equal to plus 5. Understood? Because this minus 10 will go that side, it will be plus 10. Understood? So x is equal to plus 5. Therefore, we can write oxidation number of phosphorus in H4P2O7 is plus 5. Okay, so this was little bit different what we have studied till now. Now the next one is D is homework for you. Homework is your D. Okay, and then D E. B, E, then G also is homework. It is easy. The remaining we will do. Okay. Then H I will do it for you. Okay, so these are the three homework what you have to do by yourself. D, E and G. Answers I will just let you know. In D the answer will be plus 6. In E the answer must be to find of oxygen minus 1, okay, and in G answer will be plus 6. Okay, so this is the homework part what you have to do. Now another one what I am going to do is A, B, C, D is home, C we have done, no, this was 3, huh? This was C. Okay, D is home, okay, B, C, D, E. Now we will do F. Okay, F we will do. Do this part. Okay, now when we say this F, no, F is little bit different, huh? It is NaBH4. This is sodium borohydride. Clear? So when hydride word comes, no, hydrogen oxidation number is minus 1. Clear? I told you when hydrogen is connected to metal. Huh? Okay. So in this case, this I think they have asked for boron. Right? So boron we will underline here. So oxidation number of boron BX in NaBH4. Okay. So plus 1 here, minus 1 and here X. Huh? So this is an important part you have to remember. Hydrogen. Huh? This is the important part. Hydride when it is there, no, it is hydrogen, it will be minus 1. So when we write here sodium, that is plus 1 plus x plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to 0. 1 plus x minus 4 is equal to 0. X minus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to plus 3. Boron in NaBH4, boron oxidation number is plus 3. Understood? So this is little bit different what we have studied till now. Now the next one, that is ABCDE, F I will do for you. No, F over, huh? This was F. G is homework. I will do H for you. Huh? So, H. Okay. Now, H when we say, no, H is potassium aluminium sulfate into 12. H2O, that is KaSO4 twice into 12 H2O. Okay, now in this case let the sulfur be X in KaSO4 twice into 12 H2O. Understood? So when we write this, in this case potassium will be plus 1, aluminium plus 3, hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2, and sulfur here it will be X. So plus 1 plus 3 plus here it is 2. So 2 into X plus 4 into minus 2. Understood? Huh? Okay. Plus this bracket we will change. Okay, plus 12 into water, that is 2 hydrogen. So 2 into plus 1 plus 2 into, sorry, plus minus, that is minus plus minus 2 for oxygen. Understood? So this way, okay. Now is equal to 0. Now when we substitute this, see, 1 plus 3 plus 2 into x minus 8 plus 12 into 2, here 12 into 2 and minus 2, that will be 0. Understood? remaining here 1 plus 3 plus 2x minus 16 plus this will be 12 into 0 is equal to 0. So 1 plus 3 plus 2x minus 16 is equal to 0. This get cancelled. Understood? So the remaining part 4 plus 2x minus 16 is equal to 0. 2x minus 12 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to plus 12. So x is equal to plus 6. 2 will go there, it will divide. So oxidation number of sulfur in KAlSO4 twice into 12H2O is plus 6. Understood? So this is the thing in different little bit. This was H question. So do it the homework by yourself. This is the way how to find the oxidation number of the given element or the underlying element. Next time we will do of polyatomic ions. So still many examples are there which we will practice in this. Understood? So I think you little bit you came to know how to find the oxidation number. So that three homework you do. If you don't get answer, just let me know on my number. I will help you out in that. Okay? So till then, watch this, the remaining video what I said, this one, to understand these topics. Okay? Thank you very much.